Arturo Bolinas, this is Detective Duval.
Hi, Arturo. What can I do for you?
Hey, yeah, it's about, this.
Our flyer? Where'd you see it?
On campus.
You go to Brayton?
Yeah, third year.
When you saw our flyer there, got your attention?
Yeah, it kind of made me go, huh? 'Cause, there's this guy, you know?
What's his name?
Scott Parrish.
And what about this made you think of Scott?
Because he's like, I mean, that's kind of what he does.
What does Scott do that makes you think that he might be a person of interest in this case?
He, like, forces girls to have sex.
Tell me about that.
Scott's not gonna know I'm the one who talked to you, will he?
Not at this point, no. How do you know that Parrish rapes women?
That's not what I said.
Yeah, it is. You said he forces women to have sex. That's rape. How do you know that Scott does this?
Everyone does. We've all, like, seen him do it. I mean, not like, seen. But, like, this one time, he got this girl so wasted, she wasn't even really conscious, and he just took her up to his room anyway.
How'd you know he was taking her upstairs to have sex?
It was obvious. I left pretty quick after that. The whole scene kind of freaked me out, you know? It just felt wrong.
What happened to the girl afterwards? Do you know?
Like I said, I left. I don't think she did anything. She just... But another time with this other girl, she reported it and Scott got arrested and everything.
The accuser claimed she'd gotten drunk at a fraternity party. Parrish pressured her to have sex, saying if she didn't, he'd, quoting here, tell everyone she was a slut. She agreed reluctantly, then changed her mind and tried to leave. Parrish restrained her and proceeded to assault her.
Victim reports the rape to campus police the next day. Campus police reported to local police. Victim declines to press charges. Charges dismissed. Anything else on his record?
That's it.